and people.
Nawe pasa moto wa mtenga wanga kuti atu anga.
My people.
Atu anga.
Now I'm going to understand exactly what is the meaning of my people.
Tili kalato tikusatula liula atu anga kuti kunena kuti chani.
What is the definition, a real definition of my people?
Kudata usakwake kweni kweni kwa liula kuti atu anga.
What is it?
Nijani.
First of all, I went into the World Dictionary.
Ndipo koya pirida ndinayangana buku la dziko lonse limene limakhala ndi matanthauzo amaso.
That book says that.
Ndipo buku limenelo likunena kuti
it's like my people means
atu anga akutanthauza
collectively. The persons collectively.
Amwana anthu pa umodzi wawo.
Or in general.
Kapena kuti mwa anthu onse mu umodzi.
Or maybe in a family.
Kapena mu banja.
And also it says a group of persons considered together.
Kapena so ikunena kuti gulu la anthu amene akulinganira zinthu.
Or persons loyal to someone who is in power.
Kabela kuti anthu amene ali pansi pa ulamuliro wa mwina wake.
That's somebody who is so powerful.
Iye amene ali wamphamvu kwambiri.
Now, I pray that as God.
Nena pepera kwa Mulungu ndi kumufunsa Mulungu.
What do you mean when you say my people?
Kodi mukutanthauza chani pamene mukunena kuti anthu anga.
Now he took me back.
Ndi anatitengera kumbuyo.
When the children of Israel.
Pamene ana a Israel.
Were in the captivity.
Anali mukapolo.
Under the control of Pharaoh.
Pansi pa ulamuliro wa mfumu Farao.
And God said to Moses.
Ndipo Mulungu anati kwa Mose.
I've heard the cry of my people. I've heard the cry of my people. And he said, go and tell Pharaoh to let my people go.
Kuti awaone anthu anga amuke.
So I realized that, okay, all these definitions of the Bible, of the world, it's nothing compared to what God took as my people. And I've just pointed out something, saying, my people is not necessarily your boyfriend. Or maybe your girlfriend. But it's still your favorite person in this matter. I mean, remove that. That boyfriend and girlfriend is somebody favorite in your life. I'm just translating. I haven't yet preached. I will start preaching soon. I want you to understand where we are going. So that we shouldn't get lost. The moment you be out of here, if you put them, and you think you go back the same way you came in, you will go the different
course.
In the name of Jesus. But I want you to be attentive.
Come on, mukale acheru kwabiri.
So nobody ever stopped.
Ndipo palibe winani Yesu amene anayimitsa.
To say this,
kunena izi,
that salvation belongs to sinners.
Kuti chipulumutso ndi chathu ochimwa.
Salvation belongs to this. Am I lying?
Kodi ndikunama?
Okay, I'll ask my brother Peter.
Peter.
Am I lying that we usually, people usually say that salvation belongs to sinners only? They are the one who is supposed to be saved.
Peter, ndikunama kuti timanena kuti chipulumutso ndi chathu ochimwa okha.
Most of people they usually say salvation is only for those sinners. We have been saved already. We don't need salvation.
And one bit that I don't need a good chipomuto, the young Wojima, if you never move to Bagan, go to the city so we can see Pomuto.
But today you're going to see something else. Because Jose is telling us here, my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. And I want us to see now who is my people. When God is talking about my people, who are they? Now let us see what is lack of knowledge. The lack of knowledge, it means that we are missing something in the things of God. We are not understanding something in the things of God. Because the Bible is so clear. The Bible is so clear that my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. Yes, the Bible is there. People are reading each and every day. They are meditating on it each and every day. I'll stop. As you are meditating the Bible, do you follow? Do you follow? Or do you leave the Bible? This is Easter, during Easter times. And that's why I plan myself in my preaching, but that is special.
I didn't
change. I plan my preachings, but God has changed it the other
way around.
So, at this time of Easter, all of you were celebrating. We were celebrating about the death and the salvation of our Lord Jesus Christ. But at the same moment, in this time as well, God is telling us that we are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. Yes, we are celebrating. But there is one way you are going to look upon today. Not salvation. Not confession. But one way.
Because you will not want to harden themselves. You have to put them down.
You